Welcome to the Sales Wolves Podcast. I am one of your hosts, Tyler Harris.
Joseph Caldwell.
And we are the Sales Wolves. Ow! What was your kind of first takeaways just overall from the event?
It really, really was eye-opening to see because we're around people that value social media. My assumption was that everybody does and everybody's building their own personal brand, building their company brand. But I didn't realize that it's more rare now than you would think, than it should be. And the cost of the barrier to entry is small now. Mm-hmm. And when the institutional money shows up, when the Coca-Colas and the Toyotas and the Fords to do what you've done with your social media, mm-hmm. will cost 1,000 times more.
Yeah. Gary made an incredible analogy, and he's used this analogy before, but he said it in a different way and kind of elaborated on it, which I thought was incredible. He said, everybody, welcome to the Sales Wolves Podcast. This is episode 53.
One. We just said it.
I can never remember. But this is episode 57. Just kidding. This is episode 51.
251.
Of the Sales Wolves Podcast. I am one of your hosts, Tyler Harris.
Joseph Caldwell.
And we are the Sales Wolves. Ow! They love it in the office here when we do that.
Love
so that's
it.
Why we made that one a little extra long for the lady next door.
She's doing an interview next door, so.
Like, ma'am, are those wolves?
The
yes, they are.
Good. All right, so there's a reason I'm wearing a hood. I have a massive head injury. And
you all knew that.
No, I'm trying to look like, what's his name?
Mark Hamill
in The Last Jedi, or the, what is it? Is that it?
The Last Jedi.
Yeah.
That doesn't make any more sense.
It does.
Like, that's. There was an extra Y on the end of that. Like, I'm trying to do this because, and then because.
No, it's the lighting in this room. It bounces off my head funny. I don't like it. So. My bald head. So
all right, guys.
I'm wearing a hoodie.
So, welcome to episode 72 of the Sales Wolves Podcast.
Did you just say 72?
We do this podcast for two reasons. Number one, to give Joseph a place to come
and feel validated.
And throw his hood up. And we're going to have a freestyle battle at the end of this episode. So please stay tuned for that. But we do this for two reasons. And what are those?
You tell them.
All right. So we do this for two reasons. Homeless Joe says we do this for two reasons. Never felt so overdressed.
You're sweating like a whore in church.
I'm not sweating at all.
What is that glistening coming off of your head? Is that oil? Oh my gosh. We need to get you some skincare kit.
It's glitter lip balm that I put on my forehead. All right, so
come on, let's get serious.
We do this show for two reasons. The first is to provide appreciation and support for salespeople, which we are of the opinion that everyone is a salesperson. You're either selling yourself to someone or selling yourself to do something every single second of every single day. And we know it's a lonely road, so you guys need support and appreciation. We're still out there selling. We know what it's like, and it's not easy. So support and appreciation. And second is to actually provide some tactical stuff that you can take, implement into your business, implement into your life, and actually help. So that's what we want to do, and that's the two things, the two reasons why
good
we do this podcast. Thank you.
Let's get on to what we're doing in
Let's get on to the show. So on this podcast, we just want to do a quick recap of Agent 2021, the event that we just got back from last week. It was hosted by Gary Vaynerchuk. It was the first ever event that Gary Vaynerchuk actually hosted. He's obviously spoken at a lot of events, been keynote speaker at a lot of events, but had never actually hosted one himself or his organization hosted first one themselves. And so we just wanted to give a quick recap, some of the takeaways that we got from that. If you haven't done so already, make sure that you have watched the Daily Bread episode. What episode will that be where we recap it? 20? It's 20. Episode 20 of the Daily Bread, where we give about a 20-minute recap of the whole thing as far as showing little clips from all the different speeches and a bunch of really cool stuff. But what was your kind of first takeaways just overall from the event? Did you get a lot out of it?
A ton out of it. Yeah. I could have left after the first 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And not to say anything bad about everybody else that spoke, but it really, really was eye-opening to see, because we're around people that value social media. Mm-hmm. So my assumption was that everybody does, and everybody's building their own personal brand, building their company brand. I just was under that impression, but I didn't realize that it's more rare now than you would think, than it should be. And the cost of the barrier to entry is small now. Mm-hmm. And when the institutional money shows up, when the Coca-Colas and the Toyotas and the Fords and the Wells Fargos and all the banking and insurance and when all that money shows up to do what you've done with your social media, will cost 1,000 times more.
Yeah.
Because the real estate will be more expensive, right?
Yeah.
And so that was an eye-opening thing right there. 30 minutes in, listening to Gary, I made the decision, and you and I've made the decision to go all the fuck in. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, to really get after it.
And Gary made an incredible analogy, and he's used this analogy before, but he said it in a different way and kind of elaborated on it, which I thought was incredible. He said, you know, everybody talks about the beachfront property in Malibu.
Right.
And how if you had that opportunity back whenever that was, years and years ago, to get that beachfront property right on the ocean in Malibu, that obviously you'd be just set up right now, like you're set for life. But everyone now thinks that the whole neighborhood is sold out.
All of Malibu sold out.
The whole neighborhood.
Malibu social media, it's all sold out.
And Gary was basically saying, do you realize that the second row, the third row, the fourth row is all still
it's
up for grabs?
Like, it's all up
like
for
right
grabs.
Across the street from the beachfront, like the second most valuable pieces of land grab that you can possibly get are up for grabs right now.
And it was funny when he was explaining what the land grab is. You're grabbing, what the real estate is there is you're grabbing attention.
Yeah, eyeballs.
You're grabbing eyeballs. You're grabbing people's attention. So that was awesome, man. When it comes to Andy Frisella, man, I love that dude. Like, he's my favorite, hands down. I mean, he's my favorite hands down. So to hear him speak and just how real and raw he is, he's my favorite, man.
Yeah, it was very real, very, very transparent. And what I love about Andy,
which he always is.
Yeah, and I told when I met with Gary at the end of that night, I was talking about this gap and who people can look for education and motivation, inspiration, and that you've got these multi-millionaires and people faking like it, nothing in between. But what I told Gary was, like, Gary's been able to bridge that gap because of his integrity and his intent behind his message.
Yeah, yeah.
Andy, too, has been able to bridge that gap because all he talks about is the hard work that went into where he is now. Like, the fact that for 7 years he never made over, like, $600-700 a month, ever. Yeah. But then now he's got, you know, what did they do last year? $170 million in revenue?
$200
million last year, and over $100 million the year before. And
$116 the year before.
Yeah, so, I mean, but he's not sitting there saying, like, hey, this is easy, follow my system and do this and do that. He's like, no, it's 17 years in the making.
And his shirt, do you remember what the front of his shirt said?
Yeah, South County.
He was like, does anybody know what that is? That's his home county, right? That's where he's from. And he's like, there's nothing but hardworking people, good people from that county, you know? And it was just fascinating. He doesn't try to be somebody he's not, you know? Like, a lot of times, you know, it's funny. That's why I'll dress down on these. A lot of times, and I just like to look opposite of Tyler. He looks like such a prick right now. but
it's quite all right.
I'm playing. But
chop chop.
But chop chop. But the reason I like to do that is because it's unrelatable sometimes, the success that we're having. Like, people look at that and go, well, if I could just hit $40,000 or $50,000, if I could just do this much. And then there's the people you're talking about that are pretending like they're so successful when they're not. Yeah. And so I almost like to pretend like I'm less successful than I am. You know what I'm saying?
Well, there's something to be said for the guy that walks in the Lamborghini dealership with flip-flops and a t-shirt.
Yeah, and buys.
And then the guy that walks in like a, you know, $5,000 suit.
Yeah.
There's just something that just feels so right about the first one. Like, it's just the best feeling.
It's awesome.
Best feeling ever when people... people judge by appearance. But so Andy's was absolutely awesome. Like, we set out, it was the middle of the day, the sun was beating down on the Hard Rock Stadium, and my back felt like it was on fire. And he was up there sweating.
He was
sweating. It was so hot, like, during that talk. But
what was the other talk that was so freaking? It was Ferry?
Tom Ferry.
Why do I keep wanting to call him Tim?
So Tom Ferry spoke, and Tom Ferry, I had zero context of him. Did you?
I had never heard of him.
And I'll say, like, every person I said that to at the conference was like, what? Because it was primarily a real estate, there was the majority of people there were real estate, and he's the biggest real estate coach, but coach just in general to successful business people in the world. But real estate,
I'm going to read some of my notes from
it.
Yeah,
well, just to give you guys some context, like, he said, like, in the top 25 real estate agents in the world, he coaches 15 of them, and I think all top five.
That's
crazy.
Sick. Yeah, that's sick success right there. And it was first thing he said, it was just so much common sense that you know and you learn along the way to success, but he has a way of delivering it that I was just blown away with. I was like, oh my gosh. And one of the things he said that most of you, your goals are here and your behaviors are here, right? So will you ever get your goals? If your goals are here and your behaviors are here, you'll never get your goals. Mm-hmm. You have to align your behaviors with your goals. And it was just fascinating. He was going through the five fundamental questions. What is your purpose? What are your superpowers? What are your values? He said, if you don't know your values, if they're not clear, then you say yes to the wrong shit. That impacted me. I was like, man, that makes so much sense. 20 years from today, how is the world experiencing you?
That's a big one.
That is a great question. That is something everybody needs to answer for themselves. And then, who would I already be if I was there 20 years from now? To see who you're going to be, it's God, man, I'm telling you. And he just gave, he dropped nugget after nugget after nugget. I took pages of notes from this guy. So, and we made some strong business decisions coming out of there.
Yeah, and one thing that I took from that too is, when you think about those, like, you know, where are you going to be in 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, those type of questions, like, I've almost worn it as a badge of, like, I don't know if you call it like a badge of hustle, the fact that, like, I don't feel like I have the ability to answer those questions because things are happening so fast right now. Yeah. You know, when someone's like, where do you see yourself in 5 years? I'm like, I have no clue, because, like, the last three have, like, been crazy. Like, I can't even fathom where I'd be 5 years from now. But coming out of that, I realized, like, well, I need to sit down and actually talk about it and think about it.
You should probably ask me where you'll be in 5 years. Because I actually knew where you were going to be 3 years ago. 3 years ago.
Man, so wise. So wise.
Look. I will tell you where you'll be in 5 years.
As long as it's not in the gutter. The biggest thing that I take away from every event, and I think this is a good piece of advice for you all, is when you go to events, the key is to build relationships with people. It's to connect with other people. You're hearing that from a guy who is antisocial as it gets, who cannot stand to have small talk and, hey, what do you do? Hey, I'm Cliff from Avenue and Fifth. And blah, 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 blah. Like, hey, I can't stand those conversations.
Are we starting the battle already? Cliff from Avenue and Fifth?
Cliff McGriff from Avenue and Fifth. I don't know where I heard that the first time, but I always, anytime I use somebody's example of their name, that's what I always say. Anyways, Cliff, if you're out there and you live on Avenue and Fifth, I'm sorry. But it's taking those relationships from there. Like, there was probably three or four people that I really, maybe even four or five, that I really connected with and have been messaging every day since. Guys like Sina Azari, guys like Dave Hutch, Guys like your Canadian best friend. Just tons of people that I connected with there that I know will grow those relationships further down the road. And that's what those things are. Like, that's the biggest ROI, is to be able to pull a couple people from every event that you can grow with, that you can help each other grow. And obviously the speakers are great. You know, all the discussions that we had on the panels, like, that's all good stuff. But it was the relationships that you can build with people. And one way to do that is, like, meeting up with them after the event. So, like, the night before, we went to dinner with four guys that we didn't know. Like, we had never met them ever before. I sent a DM to a couple of them on Instagram saying, like, hey, we're going to be at the Hard Rock. If you're coming to the event, come hang out, say what's up. Like, that Jason from Saber, he came by. So I'm having dinner with Jason in New York City February 8th.
Awesome.
Him and a couple of the guys.
What are you doing up there then?
On the 9th, we're gonna be interviewing Gerard Adams.
Oh, that's fun.
Up there.
Kim might be up there at that time seeing Hamilton.
How many times is she planning on seeing Hamilton?
I do. Wait, is she going to see him? I think she is going to see Hamilton.
She's
going,
like,
to another play, I think.
Gotcha.
Maybe.
But that's the key is, like, doing something after the event. Like, you can say, what's up? Hey, how are you? Like, have those little, you know, nothing conversations while you're there. But it's meeting with them afterwards. So we hosted a meetup after Agent 2021. We did it at a good friend of mine's.
Yeah, Kim will be in New York, too.
Really?
Sometime. Yeah.
Huh, awesome.
And Laney.
That's awesome. So we hosted a meetup afterwards at a good friend of mine from high school at a restaurant that he just opened. And we just kind of threw it out there. Hey, if you want to come by, a bunch of people showed up. We did live podcasts from the patio there. TJ's mom showed up, which was awesome.
That was awesome.
We got to meet her.
A lot of fun hanging with her.
And it was just cool, like, getting to like really get to know people beyond the setting of being in a, you know, event.
Right, right.
Which is the key to all of it. So that's
and
pretty
the thing
much
that I look for there is I just look for authentic people.
Yeah.
People that want to just be real and that are open about where they are, where they're going. That's what you look for, because those are the types of people that you can really form solid relationships with. They built on trust over time and literally, man, do things together down the road. That's when you find people that you're going the same direction with.
Yeah.
It's special.
So Asia 2021 was great. I know next year is going to be way better.
Yeah.
Year after that. I think they're going to do it every year up until 2021.
You're going to do it four times.
I bet next year is going to be sick, though. Like, now that they've kind of figured out, ironed all the kinks out, they can really get some really laser-focused panel discussions and all that kind of stuff. And it's an industry that needs it at the end of the day. The automotive, travel, and then real estate and insurance were the two big ones that were represented there. So nothing but positive stuff to say coming out of there. And I just want to do a quick recap and let you guys know how it went. Again, make sure you check out episode 20 of the Daily Bread, because we actually show a bunch of the footage from throughout. So you'll see me and Joseph walking in and out and up and down escalators and and riding Ferraris and crazy things like that.
That was fun.
It was a lot of fun.
A lot of fun.
So with that is episode 94 of the Sales Wolves podcast, or 51 of the Sales Wolves podcast. Again, I am Tyler Harris.
Joseph Caldwell.
And we are the Sales Wolves.
Yes, sir.